Hi, welcome back to Element 14 Presents. I'm Katie, and in today's episode, we're going to be... Hang on a second. Right, in today's episode, we're going to be making a doorbell alert system.
Amazing hacks. Inspired designs. Each week, Element 14 Presents brings you innovative projects using electronics, engineering, and more.
We've got a bit of a problem here that when someone rings the doorbell, depending on where I am in the house, some places I can't hear it at all, so I don't know that someone's at the door. Other places, like in my workshop, I can't quite often get to the door in time before they've given up and gone away. I'm going to come up with a way that I can alert myself wherever I am in the house, whether that's in the middle of the garden or in my workshop. And I'm going to come up with some sort of way that I could tell the postman that I am coming to the door. So let's have a look at how I'm going to go about doing this. So the way I'm going to have a look at this is I'm splitting it into two problems. The first problem is I can't hear the bell if I'm in my garden shed workshop. My solution here is either something portable I can take around, something I can hook into to see that the door has been rung, and having another alarm for the doorbell that can actually be in my shed or workshop, because I would probably be able to hear that from the garden as well. And my second problem is that I quite often can't get to the door before they wander off if I'm in the back part of the house or the garden or a shed. So my solution to that is to have some sort of way I can feed back to the delivery person that I'm on my way to make sure they wait. So I'm thinking for that having a screen that will just be able to display that I am actually coming. So they're my two ideas to solve the problem. So now let's have a look at the parts. Right, so my parts have arrived. I made it to the door in time for this one. So let's have a look at what I've ordered to work with. Right, so this project is going to have two parts as I've been thinking about it. I've got the doorbell alert system and the informing the post person that I am on my way. So the alert system side of it, these are the doorbells we use in our house. I'm thinking rather than starting completely from scratch, I've got these, they work. So I'm going to take this apart, see what's inside. When the doorbell is triggered, this lights up. So I'm going to see if I can connect in to that line and use that trigger for the lights to trigger off this ESP that I'll then program to send out an MQTT message, which can be picked up by the screen that's on the door as well. So I've got these buttons that if I press the button, I'm thinking it will be able to show on the screen I'm coming. Give some feedback to the post person that the doorbell has actually rung, and I can let them know that I'm on my way. I've got a couple extra switches because there's times where we write messages on our door to say we're in the garden, please come round the back, or we're out, please leave parcels in the shed. So I could also set those if we're out. So that's this side of it. And then for the door, I've got a hyperpixel to display the message that the doorbell's rung, that I'm coming, or where to leave the parcel. And I've got a Raspberry Pi 3 Model A Plus to connect to that. So I can run Mosquito on here and use that to process the MQTT messages and display on that. I've got a power supply for that as well. So my first step is going to be to take apart this doorbell and see what's inside. So these are the doorbells we've already got in the house. They weren't the cheapest ones, but they seem fairly good quality, and the ones we've got have been working for nearly 3 years. I'm going to see if I can use them in my project, save making it all from scratch. This bit goes on the door and is just one complete unit that triggers this door, the house side ringer. So I'm going to leave the doorbell part as it is for now and see what I can find inside the main unit. Right, so here's the main PCB, and then not so good. That wouldn't actually pass any UK compliance testing because those bare contacts in the back. So I think I'm going to need to take this out and see if I can use the PCB and get rid of this dodgy mains part. So this board comes out. It's got the connection to mains there, which isn't pretty. This unit looks like it could just come out of the housing and be replaced, which is more worrying because that means you could potentially leave that in a plug socket. I thought these were fairly good doorbells, but it appears not. So looking at it, it looks like there's two halves of this PCB. And there's a 0 ohm resistor there that actually links the two halves. We've got this half, which has got the circuit for picking up the signal and for ringing the sounder and for lighting up the LEDs on the front of it. And then I'm thinking if I take off this ohm link, it will just disconnect all that mains power. And then actually on the other side of here, there's two pads, one labelled 5 volts and one labelled ground. I'm guessing I can disconnect the mains and I might just be able to put in the 5 volts and the ground onto those two pads and power the other half of the circuit without the mains. So I think that would be really good. I'm going to give that a go and see how that works. So I need to take this resistor off and then I can just keep this part of the circuit. And I think my best bet's going to be able to hook into there. There's a FET which seems to be driving the LEDs, so hopefully I can trigger a GPIO pin of a microcontroller with that instead. So this is the circuitry I'm using. This is the ESP8266. I've got the bell signal coming in direct from the existing doorbell PCB. That's going into GPIO 3, and I've then got button 1, 2 and 3 coming into GPIO 0, GPIO 1 and GPIO 2. This is running off 3.3 volts and I've got a 5 volt power supply, so my 5 volts is coming into this barrel jack, and then it's being converted here to 3.3 volts. And then this is my push buttons, so when the button is pushed it makes the circuit and the LED will go on to show you that it's currently active, and then B1 when the button is pressed will be pulled to ground, and that's what the ESP will look for.
Are you an engineer, electronics hobbyist or maker? Join the Element 14 community, where you can learn about new products and technologies, see cool projects and connect directly with the people that make the products and engineers that use them. Join now!
So this is the 3D printing designs I've got. So I've designed them all this time in OpenSCAD. I've mocked up a rough size indication of the PCB I've taken out of the old doorbell system. So I've just made it some standoffs to screw it into. So you can see those underneath there. I've made a holder for the speaker that was on the original doorbell because I'm going to move that over. And then I've got a space that will hold the ESP8266. This is quite tall because it's got pin header on it, come down from the back. So that will sit there. I've got a little recessed area to hold the 3.3 volt voltage converter. I've got holes for 3 push button switches, 3 LEDs to show which I've activated of these, and a hole in the side for the DC barrel socket. So that's all in there. And I've also made a lid to fit on that. So that's for the ringing system. And then I've got this for the Raspberry Pi and the HyperPixel screen. There's a slot for the HyperPixel to sit inside of, with the Raspberry Pi attached on the back, a cutout so I can get to the ports for the power and plug in HDMI and things if I need it. I've got two screw holes. I've got the back plate, so those holes line up with that, so I'll be able to put in a nut and bolt and connect the front and back together. And on the back, I've got these standoffs where I'm going to attach the Raspberry Pi. So the Pi's held onto the back, put into the front, and then it's all kept together with these two. So it should be a nice and secure design. The other thing I've done is on the front, I've left these two big areas either side. I've got some super strong double-sided sticky tape, but it's more of like a gel. I've used it in other stuff, it works really well. So I'm gonna put a big strip of that on each side and it should hold it really securely to the window that we've got in our door. So I can mount it behind the glass and they can see it, but it's all water resistant because it's in the house. So I'm gonna send all this to the 3D printer, get it printed, and then we can assemble all the electronics inside. So I sent all those files to the 3D printer and I've got my parts. So this is the front for the screen and the Pi to stick to the door, and the back of that one. And here's the main unit, and there's the back for that one. So now I'm going to start assembling all this together. So the first one I'm going to assemble is the door part. So this is the Raspberry Pi with the HyperPixel 4 on it. So I've just assembled the HyperPixel with the header and then the Raspberry Pi. I've had to find some slightly longer bolts than came with it. I line these up here with the holes. So now that's securely attached onto there. I'm going to peel the protective bit off the screen, slot this on. I've got the holes there so I can still get to the ports. I'm just going to make a mark where I need to cut those off and use the tool that will cut them. And there we have that one. So now this one, I need to start assembling it and then solder all my buttons and LEDs together. I'm going to start with this. I've put a little blob of hot glue where these wires are connected just so they don't pull off. So that's all in there. These two connectors go together for the ESP8266. So I've already connected the signal from the doorbell to GPIO0. But I've got the other three to still make, which are going to the switches. So I'm going to get those all connected up now. So here's both of them assembled. I've got them both powered up. So the original function of the doorbell still works in this box. Like that. I have got that MQTT topic that could be subscribed to hear that alarm as well. I didn't need to pick that up in this box because it's got the sounder. I'd really like to have like an Android app so it could tell me on my phone wherever I was. If anyone's got any good suggestions for how to write Android app, I would be really interested. Please let me know on the Element 14 community, because it is something I'd quite like to learn. We'd like to get that working. I still need some help. Here's our HyperPixel with our Pi in it. So at the minute it's saying to ring the doorbell. Rang the doorbell. So I've now, inside the house on my way to the door, got three options. I can say, I'm just coming, please wait. I can turn that off. Or the other two are for things I quite regularly leave pinned to our door on a piece of paper. So I can say, please leave parcels in the shed, and I can turn that off, And my third is We're in the Garden. So here we have it on the door. We've got our message, please ring doorbell, the doorbell over here. But then we can also display the other messages like just coming, please wait, please leave parcels in the shed. And finally, we've got the we're in the garden message. So I'm really pleased with that. It's all ready to go and hopefully I won't miss any more parcels. So I'm really pleased with how the doorbell's gone. I've got the really nice unit on the door. It looks quite nice, grabs your eye. You can see the message nice and clearly. So, and I've also got my workshop unit here on my desk, so I can press the button to say I'm coming, or I can leave my other messages. I'm hoping that we won't end up having to go to the depot so often to pick up parcels or wait for the next day for them to be delivered. That will be really handy and really useful. So I've also been thinking about it. I know there's some people who don't have this sort of setup stuff. If you're living in a block of flats, it might get left in a communal area in your slot. So something like this might not be applicable. But I did think maybe you could reverse it round and have the button where your mail gets delivered. And if you could convince your post person to press the button, then maybe it could inform you that the post is there. Save you having to keep coming down and checking if you're waiting for something important and you don't know when it's going to arrive. So that might be a good idea. If you're in that sort of situation, let me know in the community. Tell me if something like that would work. But for now, that's it. So I'll see you next time.